got a lot of requests to cover this topic, so here we go, giving y'all what y'all asked for. So basically, Nicki Minaj is set to expose YouTube and Atlantic Records soon on her next Queen Radio for stealing her views. Lyor Cohen, to be exact, and I will make this as quick as possible. First off, Nicki is never afraid to go against the big dogs, especially not of recently. She was just saying that Travis Scott's manager, Irving Azoff, who is one of the heads at Ticketmaster and Live Nation, had a smear campaign against her to ruin her image and make it seem like her tour wasn't selling or whatever. Back in August, Live Nation said that her tour was canceled because sales were completely disappointing, that she was doing as low as 1,000 out of 20K, with just weeks of the show left to start, so they had to pull the plug. Nicki came back and promised her inquiring buyers that it was not canceled, but instead postponed, but Ticketmaster reps confirmed to people via email and phone that it was in fact canceled, not postponed, and the screenshots from those barbs should be on your screen. They assured them that it won't be happening, that whatever tour she comes back with for the North American leg will no longer be a Nicki Hendrix tour, but a whole different one. In fact, Future will no longer be on it. And
Cocksucker of the Day Award goes to Irving Azoff, who works over at Ticketmaster. He manages Travis Scott. Now, I know you have power and you have money, but I have balls.
This man allegedly tried to put out a smear campaign against my tour.
May God be with you, Irving. Y'all talking about what a queen is supposed to do and how a queen is supposed to act? There's never been a queen in the history of this world who hasn't been told she's crazy. You know what's bitter? My dick. Suck it. Now, how you like the taste of that? You like that, Irving? You like that? You like it? Suck it some more, bitch. I'm not going any fucking where. I'm not going any fucking where.
As you just heard, Nicki wasn't afraid to go head to head with him. And now she's coming for another big shot in the industry, Lyor Cohen, who is basically a music industry executive who's been in it for like forever, since like 1983. He used to work with Run DMC, he used to oversee deals for Rockefeller, Murder Inc., Rough Riders, Disturbing the Peace, just to name a few. 300, he signed Fetty, Migos, Young Thug, his resume is long. And right now, he's currently the head of music here at YouTube and is accused of being a complete culture vulture. But he says he fell in love with music, which is why he got into it. People are saying that he invented the 360 deals that basically screws artists over where they don't even see the money that they should make. He claims that back in the day he made $14K a year, but now his net worth is $75 million. So you can go figure. Anyway, the point is that he's a culture vulture according to many in hip hop. Dame Dash called him out on it and wants all the smoke.
He figured out a way to make other money. So he invented the 360. He's cancer for the culture.
Like, if I really feel like it, I could put some money on his head.
I want to smoke with Lyor.
He says this man profits off of making rappers go at it, had him fake beef with Jay-Z, which led to Rockefeller breaking up, that he hates what this man has done to the rap culture, period. That he signs artists that promotes lean, which he denied, but then Charlamagne pressed him on.
They're making it cool to be drinking lean.
It's the most dangerous thing facing our society.
Why sign an artist that would promote that?
I already answered that question. You weren't paying attention. I can't give up on people.
You don't think that's hypocritical though?
It's opportunistic. I got people to feed.
You're going to make Dame Dash take this clip and call you a culture vulture.
Ooh. That sounds a lot like, but yeah. Dame wants to know why somebody who's not even in the culture running it. But now, Nicki is about to spill the tea on him and wants Dame Dash to holler at her, as y'all see on y'all screen. She believes that Atlantic is working with him, and has been for some time now, to freeze and lower her YouTube views to make it seem like her career is tanking while their artist looks inflated. Videos like Chun-Li, Bet, and even her features have not been doing so good on YouTube on the outside looking in compared to her competition, whose views surpasses hers in a short time.
It's been 8 years, but I broke the record.
And it's not hard to figure any of this out, as Nicki Minaj has been publicly liking the following tweets and wants everyone to know these things. And I quote, YouTube is currently under fire by both mixers and barbs for allegedly altering the views for the Woman Like Me video. Fans say the views were reaching 10 million views, but YouTube reduced them to 3 million. Mind you, at the time we screenshot the views, it was at 7 million. So let's see if they will reduce. Her fans have been telling her that they've been seeing her views decrease for a minute now, and will address it on Monday. As y'all can see, she also liked the tweet that said that she's about to expose, honey. Child, there's a lot. If you got more time today, check out the rest.